here, which is very exciting, I think, for everyone, is we have two ensembles instead of one. We broke the 100 member mark, so we broke it into two groups. And it gives the opportunity for both groups to be challenged in different ways. And it's just been a wonderful learning experience for both groups. We are going to now slow things down a little bit with a tune entitled A Winter's Carol.
Thank you.
friend, Tommy the Elf.
What do we have here? You guys ready for a story? All right, maestro. Before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that Saint Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds. While visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief. And I in my cap. Had just settled down for a long winter's nap. Such a clatter. I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With the little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they met with an obstacle mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and Saint Nicholas too. And then in a twinkle I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney Saint Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his sack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry, his droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a round little belly that shook when he laughed, like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned on the door, and laying a finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and they all flew away like the down on a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all!"
everyone have a green program instead of a blue one? If you have a green program, don't worry, I'm not going to make you come up on stage. But if you happen to have a green program, a gift from the bands to you, please take one of these poinsettias home. Auditions back in late October. We were lucky to have several people audition for Allstate. I'm going to ask them to stand when I read their name. If you could hold your applause until I get through all the names, I'd appreciate it. Audra Schultz, Nicole Wickhart, Chad Keitel, Colton Kurtz, Brian Kalkoff, Anna Rhine, Balam Lopez Alacron, I'm working on it, Balam, John Petrozelka, Colton Williams, and Andre Florianovich.
Thank you.